Hugh.
Hugh.
Alright. So, what does Vijamu mean?
Vijamu is the knowing or wisdom. Vija. Mu is nothing. So the knowing or wisdom of nothing.
Do you have a sense of why you came here and here as opposed to somewhere else?
I had heard when I had started studying spirituality or concepts of spirituality that if I was to come across a master, it would be passive on my part, and I would be, you know, the master picks you type of thing. Mm-hmm. So I had honored that concept and never really sought out anyone to study with personally. And as I had explained earlier, this coming here was passive on my part. It was not planned. I didn't look for TCG, I didn't call him. Mm-hmm. So it was through Denpo. I drove out another student out here and asked if, because of the circumstances, see if this is it. It turned out it was.
Great. What is TCG?
What is TCG?
Yeah. Like, TCG is a person, right. But like, what else?
Are you asking about, like, Master Incarnate? Or are you asking...
Well, to you, TCG is what?
Well, to me, he's that. He's the master. Mm-hmm. So he's somebody that... I'll choose my words carefully, but it's someone who's had to live a certain type of life as a demonstration to those that can use that. I can see how that life can be lived with discipline, insight, living for a different purpose. So I can see what it looks like.
Hmm.
Experiment. If I obviously don't have the same karma, but at least take those kind of lessons and see how much deeper I can go.
Hmm. In your view, what does the CG do? How does he function relative to your path?
That's kind of it. Is not okay. So not only as a demonstration, but also as somebody who can articulate that.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of texts or spiritual guides that kind of get into this. It can't be spoken. Whereas he will speak it, will say it.
Mm-hmm.
So it can be spoken, it can be communicated. It does depend on how open the student is. But so that's what he's able to do, to live it, to speak it, and then depending on your openness, go deeper, you'll get mm-hmm. more open.
How about your openness?
What about it?
How does TCG function relative to you and your openness?
So we're all the same in the regard of we're all spirit beings
mm-hmm.
waking up, and what level of consciousness are we to that waking up?
Mm-hmm.
So his clarity to that will allow people of different openness or awareness to be here and to go deeper if they so choose.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what it is for me. Is he understood almost immediately my level of openness to this, and did what he does as far as kind of cutting deep,
yeah.
Giving me the opportunity to, if I could, shed some ego,
mm-hmm.
And then move forward with that. So then, you know, it's a give and take. Now it's on me, and if I can go deeper and move forward, then he'll cut me deeper next time. Mm-hmm. There's always more to go.
What is he cutting into, and what is he cutting away?
Just that ego. Showing whatever you've perceived as your problems or burdens are not only self-inflicted, but they're not, because they're self-inflicted, they're not real. You just have to stop
mm-hmm.
self-inflicting. And that's tough. It's tough to hear as an ego being that, oh, I'm responsible for this. Because even if you're not putting it on a person per se, you're putting on another. And so to have it come back on you is, in certain terms, kind of devastating. And so if you can push through that, then it gets easier. Mm-hmm. Then it gets hard again, then it gets easier. Kind of go through that trip.
Yeah. Are you here, do you think, because you're following the path of a particular tradition? Or is Tsuji part of a lineage that you were already hooked up with, or is he something else?
He's something else. There's definitely references to those lineages, Catholicism, Buddhism, Hinduism. So the elements are there, and they work for communication on some point, but it's different. It's more of the source of those religions. If those are religions, what they're trying to get to is more of where he's functioning. It's kind of the source of that. Hmm.
Do you know anybody else who plays guitar like the CG?
No. No.
And what would that mean to play guitar like Tsuji?
Well, it could be any instrument, but to essentially come at it from another place, another space. So it's no longer a musical concept. Music is kind of the accidental, like we perceive it as music, so we can call it that, but it's not from any theory or musical foundation. It's mm-hmm. way more emotional. Mm-hmm.
Do you feel like he walks the path of a teacher?
Yes, that's the demonstration. He has to.
Yeah. What is a teacher?
In this regard?
Well, what has a teacher been for you?
I mean, that can have different meanings. A teacher can be anyone that can clearly convey or in a way that I can or anyone can receive information. Mm-hmm. It can be that simple. So the type of information here is way deeper than any methods or practices of an instrument or anything like that. So this is going deeper, and to a degree we don't know the answers that we're going to find. If I sit and I practice, I don't know what's going to come up. And I'm sure he's had peeps come and go, pass through, take what they could and go. So for me anyway, this has always been rejuvenating. I always feel something coming back here. And I always feel something going deeper in the practice. So I have a resonance here. Hmm.
It seems like you've sensed that he is living from a realization. What do you think that realization is?
I mean, this would be coming from a student, so it would be totally hypothesized, but mm-hmm. it would be from the real, knowing what the real is, mm-hmm. And not intellectually knowing it, but being kind of forced into it, karmically speaking. So, and he's told stories, and he has a bio that kind of paints that picture of this isn't a choice for him. Mm-hmm. It's something that he's been, and in fact, there's been stories where he was choosing not to participate, mm-hmm. and what price that he had to pay for that, and then practicing what price he has to pay to do that, or to teach, I should say. So it's something that is been put on him so that any student that can see it or use it can use it, mm-hmm. Can go deeper themselves, and then we can hopefully maybe pass something, some amount of that along.
Cool. Hugh. We were just talking about your individual experience as a person here who is in residence with the CG, visits the CG, plays music with the CG. Has read his writings, sits with him, whose practice is very much in association with Bafu, and how that has kind of changed your reality and brought you closer to what you said earlier, realization or centeredness or neutrality or something like that. Can you elaborate?
Yeah, so in coming here, the questions were very heavily geared towards, you know, what should I be doing? What do I need to do differently? I don't like where I am. So I need to do something differently. And the first concept was to stop. Mm-hmm. Don't do anything. And you'll be lucky if you can not do anything type mm-hmm. of thing. So for the first, and even continuously, the exercises to do just that is to stop and listen, pay attention, see what's driving you, and then decide if that's worth keeping, if it's the right time for it, if it's even something that you want to own, if it's mom or dad, if it's whatever, mm-hmm. an experience. And just to have that dramatic of an insight initially was pretty powerful, and it began to put things in a place where I did see the control I had. So that was the danger of before, is trying to do everything, fix anything, and I'm not disciplined, I don't know what's going on, mm-hmm. basically guessing. So that kind of took a little bit of the guesswork out, so I could see more clearly without the muck and mud, mm-hmm. And then move with more intention, more centered. Mm.
You just used an interesting word, discipline. How has being here changed your understanding of what discipline is?
It not so much has changed the definition as much as I've been able to apply it to an area of my thought, feeling, my process that I never would have known that was a possibility to. In fact, if I even had read it, I might have dismissed it as impossible. Mm-hmm. But that's the benefit of Tsiji, is to see like, oh, that's a real thing. It's possible and necessary. So, and of course, initially stopping, while it sounds like an easy, oh, you just have to stop and pay attention, it's hard. It's difficult, completely difficult. Yeah. But that's the discipline, is like, all right, let's keep doing it. So it's not a problem that it's difficult. It's just another chance to focus it. That's it.
Yeah. And some people have even commented, well, Tsiji is a homegrown monastic. Mm-hmm. Has that language, monastic, like that particular word, come up for you?
Yes. Before here, I was able to acknowledge that there were distractions. I just didn't recognize them as me mm-hmm. at the moment. And so there was a point where I was even considering, like, maybe I need to be in a mountain somewhere, or maybe I need to that's how to physically remove all the distractions. And we had even talked about that concept. But he, like you said, he is living the monastic, he's the monastery. I'm the monastery, that kind of vibe. So by being able to have this practice and to center and to go deeper, yeah, maybe some peeps need to head in the trees, and it's not a thing I'm gonna say you have to or have to do, but for me it was, this may not be necessary. So that's another type of clarity.
And monastic is often not associated with creativity. I think that those two words out in the world are perhaps not often related. But here, it seems like it's a different demonstration, a demonstration of what creativity is. How has his demonstration of creativity revealed the spiritual to you?
So with the conflict, at least out in the world of maybe we'll say instead of monastery, like discipline in creativity, it's because creativity, at least coming from a music school, creativity usually is referred to the intellect or the intellectual. What kind of ideas can you come up with? What kind of patterns? And whereas a more pure experience of creativity is in the discipline or the simple, is going so deep that you are more empty, you're clearer to act as kind of a vessel. Mm. So while intellect is definitely something that can be used to have that pass through, it's not necessarily the thing to worship in and of itself. And that was my repulsion from the music I was learning in school, was it was very thought-based. And I mean, on one level I dug it, but on another level, I didn't feel anything for it. So that kind of led to some kind of crisis. Hmm. But I think that's the conflict versus the what I feel is to be the more true nature of creativity. Hmm. It is that discipline. Hmm. And granted, it is difficult because in the practice, it is hard to articulate, you know, what's going on. You know, you're kind of searching through the dark for a little bit. So it's hard to answer to that. It's kind of an experiment you're waiting to see. Mm-hmm. So how long can you do it? How long can you hang in? What kind of insight can you get? And just push for deeper if you can't.
Mm-hmm. How has playing with DCG kind of helped this crisis that you just mentioned evolve? And what has been revealed to you through playing?
Most of what I see as like residual ego to work through or to cut clear has been shown through the drums, through us either playing hand percussion together or him playing guitar and drums, because there is nothing to hold on to. We may start with some kind of time or form to kind of come up with this, you know, small agreement, but these aren't tunes. These aren't forms that we're agreeing. We're gonna see how we get through. There's nothing to hold on to. So whatever is there is gonna be laid out, whether mm-hmm. you like it or not. Mm-hmm. And then depending on what he's trying to convey, he can make it more dramatic or we can make it a little bit more chill, but it usually was pretty dramatic. So that was obvious as soon as the first time we played, was everything that I was lacking was thrown out there.
Hmm. And do you feel like you are working towards the same thing that everybody else who comes here is working towards?
I mean, that's on some level, yeah. If the concept is we're spirit first, then yes. Mm-hmm. How we get there or what we work through will be different. I have my own karma. I have my own baggage. And that will look differently as I shed that as someone else.
Yeah. Has what he teaches been proven to you completely?
As complete... I mean, whatever concept of completion is, yeah. I mean, has there ever been a time where I was like, I disagree with this idea? I mean, yes, in the beginning, but I always gave gave way to the experiment, because that's kind of a duty. Even in the music world, that's kind of your duty as a student. If you're studying with someone, you take their ideas, you use them as much as you can, and if it doesn't work, it doesn't. If it does, it does. So I always submitted to the experiment or whatever the recommendation was. And then I found, no, this is it, it's working. Hmm. So that's one of those dangerous areas, because a repulsion could be instinctual, it could be gut, it could be psychic, it could also be bullshit. So mm-hmm. how do you know? So that's, fortunately we have a way of getting quiet, mm-hmm. letting things kind of work through, and then just opening.
Yeah.
And then there is a certain kind of knowing.
Do you feel as though at a certain point you will be done here?
Again, it's like as complete as it could be, as done as it can be.
Yeah.
When that time comes, if that time comes, it will be clear.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the work that I feel I have to do, I don't necessarily see or foresee an end like mm-hmm. that.
Do you have a goal relative to either your own level of achievement or spiritual unfoldment?
Because the depth can't be known, at least to the egoic mind or the conscious mind, I can't, the goal is just continuous. It's just mm-hmm. to keep going. So anytime there's, for whatever reason, the lower world pulls you out for a moment and you have to deal with whatever feels real at the time, and just getting back in. And that's the continuum. So that's as much of a goal as I have. It's just to keep going.
And it's probably safe to say that, or to assume that you feel as though what is being offered here, what's being lived here and demonstrated here and played here and written here is profound. What does profound mean to you?
That it speaks through, again, that kind of clutter. Because there are things that will appease certain aspects of ego, and you can end up worshiping that thing. So for some people, it's an emotion. If they feel, you know, something for it, they end up worshiping that thing that makes them feel that way. Here, that cuts past that. Cuts past kind of the intellectual, cuts past the emotional, cuts past any drama. And so because it does that, and I feel that it does for me, I mean, that's pretty profound. It's like nothing but honesty here. There's no wiggle room. Sometimes he refers to it as the practice is kind of walking on the razor blade, where if you fall off, you feel that, and you get back on, you feel that as well, getting cut. So, that's pretty, for me, that's pretty profound. That it can do something, someone can do that.
What's the process been like for you realizing, like, what has the unfoldment process been like for you? Because it's, you know, it can be so vastly different for people depending on where they're coming from.
Yeah, you mean like the physical changes that have happened or the...
Anything that's been significant for you.
Well, I mean, it completely changed my concept of social behavior, relations, I want to use polite words, but lost a lot of connections that needed to be lost, type mm-hmm. of thing, relations that needed to go. Some relations changed, and some few, but some gained. But basically put in some kind of order where it's no longer a dependency on that. Like, I need to be this to this person and this to this person. I need to be seen in this way. It's not necessary. So that was one of the initial changes. Kind of, again, same thing with the monastery. Kind of becoming that monastery of like, all right, I'm here. If people need to pass through, they can. But I'm no longer necessarily reaching or growing attachments to. And then changed, definitely organized my approach to music, made me go back to the roots of it, to the discipline, so that I could experience maybe a truer level of creativity, of speaking, as opposed to a pedagogic, you know, this is where this is derived from, this is where this is derived from, now go give your impression of that and hopefully you'll survive. So definitely wiped that out and went more to the source.
And how has TCG exceeded your expectations of what a musician can be and also what a teacher can be?
That's tricky because I've tried not to have expectations in that way
mm-hmm.
of everything. And even he would, in the beginning, kind of say things like that. It's like, don't believe this. Like, do it. Then believe it. Mm-hmm. Then do. Then, see for yourself type of thing. I guess as far as exceeding is just that some of these things that I had originally thought before meeting him were either virtually impossible or only for those living in mountains and monasteries, that it was impossible for your average folk. So that I guess exceeded an expectation. Mm-hmm. Oh, I guess it is. Well, and I get more importantly, not that it was possible, but it was also necessary. That was key. So then to see it and be like, all right, that's cool, you can do it. But then to also understand, like, I have to get on this. Mm.
Is there anything else you want to add about your experience as a student, as a musician, as a practitioner?
I mean, it's, like I said, it's given me kind of this blissful neutrality, so that the work is the focus, the practice is the focus. Whatever else happens is not a drag. If anything super blissful happens, I can enjoy that for the moment, but it's always back to work kind of thing. So it's purpose. It's purpose. It's much less searching. Mm. I want to use the word happiness, but obviously not of an emotional nature, just of a nice, everything's cool. And to find that. Great. So lucky and grateful.
Yeah. It is amazing that this scene exists, that the city plays music and writes books and exists, and that people come and sit and are, shown what they need to see. Yeah. So thanks for sitting and talking and answering questions.
Thank you for asking.
Yeah. Well, always.
Hugh. Always Hugh.